Hello everyone, I am Professor S.N. Mane, Assistant Professor KKVA College of Agricultural Engineering and Technology, Nashik. Today we will learn about peeling and what are the different peeling methods and the devices. So let's start. See, what is meant by peeling? Peeling is to remove the unwanted or inedible material from the vegetable raw materials. It may be the fruit or the vegetable. Now, what is the purpose of peeling? See, peeling, it is used for improving the appearance and the taste of the final product. Now, during the peeling, peeling losses need to be minimized by removing as little as the underlying food material in order to achieve a clean peel surface. Okay, that's why we can avoid the post-harvest loss or our main product loss. Okay, when we remove the little amount of the peeled material from the food material, then we can maintain or we can avoid the loss of that fleshy portion or the main food product of a particular fruit or vegetables. Okay. Generally, this peeling is carried out in order to increase the appearance of a final product. Also, in case we want to convert that raw material into the finished product, in that case, their taste, it should be remain as it is, or to increase their taste of that value-added product, we have to peel our particular raw material, that is fruit or vegetable. Now, let's start. What are the different methods of peeling? Before that, which kind of the material it is going to be peeled? See, any kind of the fruit or vegetables, then basically root crops or the tubers like potatoes, this kind of the commodities, it can be peeled. Now, what are the different methods of the peeling? In which first one is the flash steam peeling, knife peeling, then abrasion peeling, caustic peeling, and last one is the flame peeling. So one by one, we will go through the each peeling method. So first of all, flash steam peeling. See, in this method, this steam peeling, it is carried out either in the batch process or in the continuous pipe process. Okay. Now see, in the batch process, what happens? The raw material which are treated, it is kept in a pressure vessel and it is exposed to the high pressure steam, which having the temperature approximately 180 to 200 degrees Celsius. Now, particular commodities like tomatoes, they are exposed with the temperature of about lower than this temperature, that is up to the 120 to 130 degrees Celsius. Now, this high temperature, it causes a rapid heating and cooking of the surface layer. Just only the surface layer it is cooked because we are exposing this high pressure steam up to the 15 to 30 second only, not more than that, because longer exposure to this steam for a particular food product, particular fruit or vegetables, it will causes the complete cooking of that commodity. Okay, so to avoid the complete cooking, just for cooking of the surface layer, we have to expose that steam for approximately 15 to 30 seconds. See, the pressure, it is then instantly get released up and which causes the flashing of this cooked skin. The continuous steam peeler is a pipe with a screw inside that pipe. A steam, it is fed direct into the pipe. Generally, this pipe, continuous type of this, now flash steam process, in which pressure is less than that of batch wise process, and this product, it is heated during the residence time. Okay, means this residence time, it is varies upon the variety of a particular commodity. Now, most of the peeled material, it is get discharged along with the steam. See, when we release the high pressure, then it flash off the our peeled material along with that steam. Sometimes any remaining traces are there, it get sprayed off with the help of potable water. Okay, then you can get a clean food product. Okay, now this is about flash steam peeling method. Now we will move towards the next method, knife peeling. Now in this method, the material which we have to pull, these are placed onto a rotating disc and it is pressed against the stationary or the rotating blades. Okay, in order to remove the skin. Now this peeling method, it is mostly used for a citrus fruit, because the citrus skin, it will get easily removed and the fruit suffers with the little damage. Okay, because See, this knife peeling method, it having a disadvantage, that is along with the removal of that surface layer, most of the time this inner portion, inner fleshy portion or the pulpy portion, it will remove along with that surface skin. Okay, so this is the one of the disadvantage of this method. Okay, so mostly this method, it is used for the citrus commodity or apple. Okay, then abrasion peeling. Next method is the abrasion peeling. Here in this method, which material which we have to cool, we have to peel, that is paid onto a abrasive rollers. Now this rollers, these are abrasive rollers which are made from the material carborundum. Okay, this carborundum material, it is used for this abrasion, and or you can fade this material into a rotating bowl. Okay, that bowl, it is also lined with a abrasive surface. Now this abrasion, already I have told you that this is made up from the carborundum material. The abrasive surface, it removes the skin, which is then washed away with the help of water. Now this process, it is generally carried out at the ambient temperature. This process, it is used for different kind of commodities like potatoes, apples, okay, any kind of the commodity you can peel. Sometimes fish product also, it can be peeled. Fish mostly it is used for the peeling purpose. This method, it is going to be preferred for that removal of that outer skin of the fish. This method, it has a disadvantage, that is, see, whatever this removed skin material, we are going to wash with the water. Okay, so that's why it creates a impurities, or it creates some effluent along with that water. Okay, so that is one of the disadvantage of this method. Caustic peeling. See, in this method, the material which is to be peeled, it is passed through a dilute solution of about 1 to 2% of the sodium hydroxide. Then this treatment, it is soften the skin. Okay, by this chemical, it is used in order to soften the skin, which can be then once that skin is softer, it will be removed with the help of high pressure water sprays. Okay, now this caustic peeling, it is divided into two types, that is dry caustic method and the wet caustic method. Okay, in the dry caustic peeling method, what happens, initially you have to dip your commodity into the dilute solution of sodium hydroxide, it may be 10%. Okay, then once that commodity, it is softened, okay, or this outer covering of that commodity has softened, then it is followed by the rubber disc or the rollers in order to remove that skin. Okay, this is the dry caustic peeling method. And in wet peeling method, what happened? Wet caustic peeling, here, once your commodity has been dipped, immersed into the dilute solution of this sodium hydroxide for a particular time, and when this skin, it becomes softened, it is get removed with the help of high pressure water spray, and it is called as a wet caustic peeling method. Also, this method, it having the drawback, that is also here in the wet caustic peeling, large amount of effluent along with the solid and water, it is created. Okay, their disposal, it is also one of the problem. Then also there is the another drawback, is that there is the use of this caustic solution, there is the colorizations of your main product, it is there. Okay, so these are some disadvantages. This method, it is used for peeling for tomatoes. Okay, lye peeling method, it is also you can call as a lye peeling method. Then last peeling method is the flame peel. Now this flame peeling method, in which a flame peeler, it is utilizes a particular conveyor belt, it may be mesh conveyor or it may be a belt conveyor. Okay, most of the time mesh conveyor, it is belt, it is used, and that is used for transporting your commodity from that your main source towards the your furnace. Okay, that furnace, it is heated at the temperature of about 1000 degrees Celsius. Now this in the flame peeling method, what happens, the skin, sometimes root hairs or the skin of a particular commodity, it gets burned off, and then it is removed with the help of a high pressure water spray. Okay, after burning of that skin or the root hairs, okay, our neck hairs, that can be transported into the particular container which containing the water, or they can be removed with the help of a high pressure water spray. Okay, this method, it is mainly used for the peeling of onions. Okay, so in this lecture we learn about the definition of peeling, what are their applications, then what are the different methods. Okay, so thank you for listening.